Bagaimana rasanya punya orang tua yang sukses dan terkenal?
I don't really feel that he's sukses dan terkenal. Because he's just my dad at home. He's not the celebrity you guys know at home.
Suka duka jadi anak seorang dosen?
Gak ada sih. Maksudnya kayak
normal.
It's normal, you know. It's like having a dad, but your dad is just talking a lot to a lot of people, inspiring them while you just sit there like, oh, why are you guys inspired? You know, just wondering like that.
Ini rahasia ya, secretnya seorang dosen atau pembicara publik tuh di luar mungkin kayaknya dielu-elukan, dipuji-puji. Di rumah sometimes you just a loser.
Yeah.
Basically.
Especially because like I'm in my teens, you know. Parents don't seem like they're as cool as they were when I was younger.
That's very true. Yeah. We watch an interview.
Oh,
yeah.
Right.
Jimmy Fallon interviewed Obama. When Jimmy said about
his
daughter,
daughters,
yeah. Started to roll her eyes.
Oh yeah.
To
exactly.
Him. Jadi dia mulai
Apaan sih
papa ini gitu. Dan Jimmy bilang, "Loh, you used to be my number one fan." Right? Kamu biasanya tuh selalu ketawa kalau ayah lucu. Sekarang kok jadi kayak gitu? And Obama asked, "How old is your daughter?" She said, 12. Okay, wait until she's 14. Because Obama said when they are 12, 13, 14, you will think that a father is a loser.
Yeah. So, yeah, exactly like that. When I was smaller, I guess
I remember,
God, my father is in Australia. He's very famous and he's working hard, you know. I think he's cool, but I started from in SMP.
Yeah.
I started to think that he's okay. He's just my mediocre dad that doesn't do anything actually. Of course, he does things. I know that.
So meaning that the perception,
yeah, yeah.
The perception from the child,
mm-hmm.
a daughter, a son. Memang berubah gitu loh. Jadi enggak selalu mereka kayaknya mengidolakan banget orang tuanya kan. They'll just think this is such a loser. And
oh,
Obama
wait,
said that.
Wait.
Yeah.
But okay, when I think that's mostly because I don't see you.
Uh-huh.
So
oh,
like
yeah, yeah,
when he asked me to accompany him like do a talk or something.
All right.
Like sometimes I pay attention and I listen to him and I think that oh, okay, he's kind of cool, you know.
Jadi caranya ada salah satunya itu I sometimes take Lita to my event. Last time was in EC, right?
Yes.
Even though it's probably is not your cup of tea the topic.
Yeah.
I mean like it's for old people.
Uh-huh.
Tapi saya paksa aja ngajak Lita, udah ikut aja and then
I just woke up, you know.
And then Lita was there. I remember it was like I had to go at 9, right?
Yeah,
and then I
woke,
texted you.
Yeah, at 8:20.
Well, we are texting by the way at home.
Yes.
It was also very.
My room was here. His room was here, and he texted. And then he said, "Tamu ikut. Do you want to come?" And then I asked, "Come where?" I'm having a talk.
Yeah, yeah.
In Bantul.
A seminar
in Bantul. And then like. I was still processing because I just woke up at 8:20. This is a very, very embarrassing thing. I wake up at 8:20, and then I asked right now. I said, "Yeah, I have to go at 9." And I looked at the time; it was 8:20. And like, Dad, why? You could have told me like, I know, yesterday or 2 hours ago, you know.
Yeah.
But oh well, I complied. So,
yeah, so I really appreciate that.
Yeah.
So and Lita said okay, and then we had fun, I think, right along the way, and also
yeah, we talked about a lot of stuff.
Yeah, and then jadi caranya salah satunya mungkin ya ngajak anak untuk ikut acara kita, tapi pastikan acara itu agak cool dikit lah ya maksudnya. When we are able to, you know, like inspire
yeah.
people, jadi it works a little bit.